Hello everyone, and welcome to the first course in the series Zero to Hero with Python. In this video, I will be introducing you to Python. Why Python? You might ask this question. Well, there are a lot of reasons for it, but the main ones are that Python has a wide range of syntactic constructions. This allows you to do many things with one language. You can develop a website and a machine learning application, both using Python. Then Python has many standard library functions available. It's not like you will be needing to download external code or external libraries for anything you want to do. Most of the operations people want to do are supported. And then finally, Python has an interactive development environment feature rich. So when you are developing applications, these features will definitely help you. But for now, in this series, we will only focus on the basics of Python. Then, what are the ways to run Python? Well, there are three popular ways in which you can run Python. The first is that you can run it on a shell or a terminal. I'll show you. So if you have Ubuntu installed, you can directly open your shell with the default shortcut Control Alt T. Otherwise, if you have Windows installed, you will have to install Python, and then you can open CMD or Python and then run it. So if you write Python 3 on its shell and press enter, you'll see this Python prompt appears. In this, you can do simple operations. You can also run it by .py files. So you can open any text editor you like. Atom and Sublime are recommended. You can open any text editor, write the code, and save the code with a .py extension. Then you can open terminal and then write the name of the file, .py. Press enter and you will see the output. And then lastly, you can run Python from Jupyter notebooks as well. But this method is mostly used by the people in the data science industry, so it's not as relevant for you right now. In this course, we will be only using the first two methods, which are running Python via the terminal and via .py files. So what are the basic mathematical operations allowed in Python? Well, these seven operations are allowed. I'll show you on the shell. The first was exponentiation. So what if you want to get the value of 2 to the power 3? So you can simply write 2 and exponents operand, which are the stars above the letter 8. Just write them 2 times. Press enter, you get an output 3. Modulus is, let's say you want to get the output of remainder of 22 divided by 6. So when you do this, you will get as output 4, because 6 goes 3 times, 18, and when you divide 22 by 6, you get 18, and then 4 as remainder. 3 as quotient, 4 as remainder. Integer division can be done by double typing the slash symbol, which is below the question mark on your keyboard. 22 integer division by 6 gives you 3, because 3 point something is the value, which in integer is 3. So division, simply we can do the similar operation, but instead of this using the double slash, we can only use a single slash, and we get as output 3.66, infinitely long. Now what about multiplication? Multiplication can be done simply by writing the numbers and a multiplication symbol in between. 5 multiplied by 4 is 20. Subtraction, 5 minus 4 again, 1. And addition, the simplest addition, 2 plus 2 equal to 4. Okay. So coming to the concept of data types, this concept is relevant whichever programming language you choose to pursue. Data types can be thought of like categories for values. Since you already know that decimal numbers, integers, and strings, they all have separate categories. As a result, they all have separate data types. Integers like 5, 6, 7, 8, so on, have an integer data type. Floating point numbers like 3.14, 223.7, 1997.2005 have a data type called float. And strings like hello, Python, 3, whatever you want between double quotes basically, belong to the data type string. But if you write a string in which you open the string with a double quotes, then you write whatever you want to write, but you forget to close the string with a double quotes. When you run that file, you will get a syntax error. And you can simply add this double quote at the end of the string to remove that error. Simple debugging. Okay, now two string operations, string concatenation and string replication. So in string concatenations, you can basically have two strings back to back. Okay, so let me write my first name and I want to concatenate it with my surname. Okay, and when I run this, so you see that I get Web of Kulshresh as a single word without any spaces in between. But be careful of the fact that when doing string concatenation, you have to have strings on both sides of the operand. If you have string on one and integer on floating point on the other, you'll get a type error. Okay, and string replication is when you want to repeat a single string a definite number of times. So now let's say I want to repeat the string Python 3 times. I can simply write Python star 3. I will get as output Python, Python, Python. Okay, variables. So variables can be thought of like containers for values. And these containers have specific names which are unique. For example, you can initialize a variable with a equal to sign. So let's say I want to make a variable x. And I gave it the value 12. So x equal to 12. Now when I write the name of the variable, I will get as output its value, which is 12. There are some restrictions on what you can keep as variable names. The name can only be one word. It can't be longer than that. It can't have spaces between. And it can only contain numbers, letters, or underscores. It cannot have special symbols like dollar sign, euro sign, etc. And lastly, it cannot begin with a number. So if I just make a random variable called 11 and give it the value 34, when I press enter, you see I get a syntax error because I started the name of the variable with a number. It can't start with a number. Okay, creating simple Python programs. I have created a simple Python program called hello.py. And don't forget to end your name with .py extension. Okay, so in this file, the first line simply prints hello world to the output. The third line takes the user's name from input, and the fourth line prints hello, the name of the user. The sixth line takes the age of the user from the input, and then you finally print the user's age after 2 years. Okay, so let's try and run this file. Okay, Python 3, the name of the file, Python 3 hello.py. When I press enter, it asks me my name, save above, what's my age? My age is 23. And it has told me, see, I will be 25 years old after 2 years, which is right. Okay, moving along. What were the parts of the program hello.py? The first was comments. Anything you write after this hash symbol, won't be executed, and comments are generally used to describe your code. It is good practice to write comments after every line or every block, explaining what the code or the block does. The next was the print function. This function prints whatever is given between the parentheses. It prints it to the output, whatever output you might have declared. Then the next function we used was the input function. It asks the user for an input, it prompts the user, and whatever you write between the parentheses is what is used for the prompt. Now, I told you about the three different data types, but how do you convert between them? Well, you can simply convert between them. I'll show you. So you run Python 3 again. And now let's say you create a variable test, and you ask the user for an input. And I give the input as, let's say, the number 23. Now, when I view the value of the variable test, it has stored the value of 23, but as a string and not an integer. So in order to view it as an integer, I need to pass it to the int function, int parenthesis test. So when I do this, I get as output my input in a, as a string, integer, sorry. So I can do the same, but instead of converting it to an integer, I can convert it to a decimal. I can simply use float parenthesis test. So I get as output 23.0 and it's a decimal. You can also convert an integer or a floating point number to a string. So let's say I want to convert string. I want to convert the number 23 to a string. So I can simply write str parenthesis 23. So you always have to be careful of the function input. Always remember that it will store your input as a string. So if you want to deal with it as an integer, you'll have to convert it. So what is the difference between the single equal to and the double equal to? Well, simple single equal to is used to assign a value. So if you see here, when I use the single equal to, I assigned the value which was given by the user in his or her input. If I want to check for the value, check a condition, I have to use a double equal to. So when I want to check whether the input is 23 or not, I can use test double equals to double quotes 23 and I get as output true. So we always remember this fact, single equals to is for assignment and double equals to is for checking for equality. Okay, so in my previous lecture, I introduced the platform Scratch to you and I asked you to make 5 programs on Scratch. I hope you have done that because in this video, I will be showing you simple Scratch programs and their equivalent Python code. Okay, so let's start. Before starting, I just wanted to let you know that whatever you write on a text editor is called as a source code. And this gets fed to an interpreter for Python, which interprets your source code into a machine code, which is what your machine reads and understands. Okay, so on the left, I will show you the Scratch programs, and on the right, I will show you their Python equivalent. So in our left, we have, when this green flag is clicked, say hello world, 2 blocks. You can simply do this thing with one line of Python, print parenthesis double quotes hello comma world. This next program, it has 2 blocks. The first block is ask what's your name and wait. The second block is say join comma answer. So I join hello comma answer, sorry. So this is a slightly more complex program in Python. In this, you have 2 lines. The first line, a variable called answer will be given the value of the input. And the prompt to the user will be what's your name, which is the same as the one in Scratch. And the second line, simply hello comma, then the user's name will be output. Okay, so this was a very simple Scratch program. It just sets the counter variable's value to 0. And you can do that in Python by simply writing counter equal to 0 or whichever variable you want to initialize. Okay, increasing or decreasing a variable's value. So change counter by 1. By using this block in Scratch, you can change the variable counter's value by 1. In Python, you have 2 ways to do the same. You can either write counter equal to counter plus 1, which is the more explicit way, or in shorthand, you can write counter plus equals 1. And you can use the shorthand for any number. It's not just for 1. You can write counter plus equal 23 or counter plus equal 2000. It doesn't matter. Okay, and this is the format for the shorthand. You start with the name of the variable. Then you write whichever operation you wanted to perform, equals to, and then the number. So like here, we have written the name of the variable counter, plus is the operation we wanted to perform, and the number was 1. Okay, so now this is an example of control flow in Scratch. So you have an if block. If x is less than y, then say x is less than y. This might appear a little more complex to you, but trust me, it's very easy. When you practice, you'll get used to it. You can do this in Python by writing if space the condition, which here is x is less than y, and then you have to end it with a colon. Be wary of this colon, you have to always insert it. Then you have to do an indentation. An indentation is generally 4 space characters or a single tab character. Then you can simply write whatever statement you want to write. Here we have simply written x is less than y, print. Okay, this is slightly more complex if else condition. So if x is less than y, print x is less than y, this is similar to what we have done before. Then here what's new is else, colon. Again an indentation of 4 space characters or at one tab, print x is not less than y. A tab is good practice. You can use a space, but I would recommend you to use tab. Okay, so this looks very complex, but it's also very easy. So the first condition, if x is less than y, print x is less than y, we have already covered. Then the next, when you want to test for multiple conditions, you will have to use the elif block, elif word, elif keyword. When you want to just test for one condition, you can just use the if and else, or just an if. But when you want to test for multiple conditions, you will have to use this elif. So elif x is greater than y, colon, print x greater than y. Third condition we are checking for is x equal to y. So x equal to y, colon, print x equal to y. But you know that when we have two numbers, we only have 3 possibilities, greater than, less than, or equal than, equal to. So we don't actually need this last condition. We can simply write else, which serves the same purpose. Okay, and what about repeating something forever? In Scratch, you have a forever block, which lets you do the same. But in Python, we don't have a forever block. So you can use a while loop to do that. So you write while space capital T lowercase rue and then a colon. And then after you give force an indentation with a tab, you can write whatever statement you wanted to write. So here while true, print hello world. What this will do is that it will keep printing hello world. I will show it to you on Python. So write while true, print hello comma world. And you can see it is keeping on printing hello world, hello world. And if I want to break out of this loop, I have to press Control and C together. It sends a keyboard interrupt, which stops an infinite loop. Okay, but what if you want to repeat something a definite number of times? You don't want to repeat something forever, right? So you can do that with the repeat block in Scratch. But in Python, you can initialize a variable. We use I generally in loops because I stands for iterator. So I equal to 0, while I, and here's the condition, I less than 50, colon. So print hello world, I plus equals 1. So keep in mind that we have an indentation behind whatever statement we want to include in the loop. So yeah, how this loop will function is I is given the value 0 and then it comes to this loop while I is less than 50. Yes, I is 0, which is less than 50. It enters the loop and prints hello world. Then I's value is incremented by 1. Now I is equal to 1, which is again less than 50. It again enters the loop and it will do so on. It will do the same until I gets a value 49. So finally, will I is equal to 49 plus equals 1 will make I 50. And so it won't be able to enter this loop because 50 is not less than 50 and it will exit out of this loop. We can do the same thing by the other way. We can initialize I to the value 50 instead of 0 and decrement I by 1 in each iteration. This will also run the loop 50 times. Instead of I less than 50, you'll have to write I greater than 0. I'll write this in the description. Okay, but what if you want to iterate over some sequence? You will have to use the for loop for that. So in this loop, range parenthesis 50, it gives you a sequence's output from 0 up till 49 with a gap of 1. So 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. So 0 up till 49, we have 50 integers. And so range is a special function, and whatever you pass between in the parenthesis is up till where the sequence will be formed from zero, and this number won't be included. So here 50 is not included in the sequence. It's only up till 49. So when you do this, this code will iterate over I from 0 to 49, which is 50 integers, and thus it will print hello world 50 times. Okay, that's all I had for you in this lecture. So I would like you to practice the basics of Python, whatever I told you in this lecture, before watching the next video. Okay, bye, see you.